Hi, and welcome back to Bali Today. You know, one of the great things about our lives in Bali is that we get to spend a lot of time out in nature. So I've just been walking through the Sawah, which is an interesting challenge. If you haven't tried it, you should. It really makes you think about forward planning. So I can go walking through nature on my way to church. Can you believe it? Aha, I surprised you. See? So right here in our little banjar in Canggu, we've got this amazing Christian church. And I'm going to go and talk to the congregation that has really strived for about 10 years to get this building finished. And we'll find out what they've got planned for their December Christmas celebrations in Bali. Come with me. Everybody's really, really busy, of course, getting ready for Hari Natal, or Christmas. But Ibu Asnat, my guest, has agreed to come and answer some of my questions. Ibu, thank you so much for coming today.
Thank you.
Now, I am so curious. For a lot of people living in Bali, we weren't aware of how strong the Christian community is here. So my question to you is, when were there Christians here in Bali?
78 years ago.
Oh my, 78 years ago.
Yeah.
So, and I believe from what people have told me, that was actually right here in this banjar where we are now.
Pelambingan. Pelambingan.
Thank you, you can correct my Indonesian, it's terrible. Pelambingan. So, go figure, for 78 years to be a religious pioneer and then to end up with this. Now, this beautiful, beautiful church, how long was this congregation saving up money and, you know, bit by bit in order to finish this?
8 years.
Oh, it's so dramatic. It's so beautiful. All right, Ibu, what we want to know, you're getting ready to celebrate Christmas here in Bali.
Yeah.
And what I'm curious about is, what are the parts of your Christmas celebration that are shared by Christians around the world?
In Christmas Eve, you know, we did it in Christmas Eve.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Yeah, so we get together, we have the ceremony, and then we'll do some recreation after that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And that's Christmas Eve?
Yeah, in Christmas Eve.
All right.
Yeah, on the 25th of December, on Christmas Day, we just celebrate it in, we do the ceremony in the church only. Yeah.
We're a bit like that. My grandmother was Catholic, so of course Christmas for her included going to midnight mass. That was part of it. But when you are Protestant in America, and of course there are many, they're not so much about the church on Christmas. It's more the family thing as well.
Yeah. We will go to our family on the next day after Christmas.
Oh, the next day?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
People will go to their hometown to celebrate Christmas with their families.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. See, after now, Christmas, not on Christmas Day, after Christmas.
Now, that's very interesting. I know as an American, when I moved to Australia, the idea that there was Christmas Day and then there was Boxing Day, that was different for me.
Yeah.
But when I came to Bali, I noticed that the Balinese have Hari Galungan for the family, and then the next day they go and visit other friends.
Yeah.
So I think you guys have it better here than in America, because we just get the one day, you know, it's a bit boring. But having 2 days is good. Yeah. Well, now the majority of your congregation are from Bali, yeah?
Yeah, they are Balinese.
Yeah. Let's see, do you sing Christmas songs when you come to church on Christmas? Do you sing Christmas songs?
Yeah, we always do that.
What's your favorite?
Yeah, White Christmas.
Oh, I love that. I'm dreaming.
Yeah. Well, I never dream of a white Christmas. You're here in Bali. How funny. Believe me, with the world climate change, you don't want a white Christmas in Bali, but it's a nice one. So, do you do Christmas trees?
Yes.
Okay.
We did it. And every house must have a Christmas tree.
Oh, yeah. We do that too, of course.
Yeah.
But you know, when I first came and asked if we could do an interview, someone, a little bird, told me that you actually, as a congregation, you go to your members' houses and help them do that.
Yeah. Sometimes if they do that themselves, we can help them to decorate the Christmas tree.
It'd be like me making panjor. You know, I couldn't possibly do a panjo without the help of my Balinese friends. Yeah. So I think that's lovely. Do you have Santa as part of your celebration for children here?
Yeah, okay, we have it. Yeah. We have some competition for the children.
And you yourself, you have a bit of a story. You're a new arrival. Yeah. Well, you've been here for how long? Ibu, how long have you been in Bali?
I have been here since 1978.
Okay. Yeah. Well, I believe, Ibu, you're a little bit like me. You came from somewhere else before and came to Bali.
Yeah.
What's your story?
I just follow my husband.
From?
My husband from here. He works here.
Sure,
as a sailor.
Fishing?
Fishing.
Oh, okay. Yeah. And where did you grow up?
At Flores.
Oh, lovely. Yeah. Lovely. So were you raised as a Christian?
Since I was born.
Of course. Of course. You must be really happy to have a congregation and a beautiful, beautiful church like this here.
I'm really happy.
Christmas, just like the ones I used to know, where the treetops glisten and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow.
Congratulations.
Yeah,
okay. And thank you very much for talking to me today.
Thank you for you too.
Thank you. All right. So that's been my visit to a church, and we already see there's so much similarities, you know, in all of us that live here on Bali today.
Now, I would like to say Merry Christmas and Happy New Year, and Selamat Hari Raya Galungan and Kuningan, and for the Muslim, I will say Selamat Tahun Baru Hijrah.
Thank you, Boo.
That's lovely. It's great.
So there you go. What a busy month we have on Bali. All right. Now, we're going to take a little break, and when we come back, we're going very, very near this Christian church to speak to our Muslim brothers and sisters there. So be right back.